All right, I've had a little change of plans. So the weather has changed here. We're finally getting some rain after 6 months here in Texas. It's just, you know, it's just been the most brutal summer ever, and it's October and I'm still sweating right now. But I was going to finish the inside of this and mask it off so I didn't have to worry about those frames, but the weather has turned humid and wet outside and the wind's blowing, so there's junk blowing around. So if I stopped and did this, I have to do it in my shop, and that's going to shut everything down because I'm going to have to, I can't stir any dust up and settle it on here. So I'm just going to go ahead and put the whole darn thing together, sand it, get it all done, and then just finish it and then reach inside, even though I know it's a pain and I'm not going to be able to do quite as perfect a job, but I'll just make it work. So I almost made a mistake here as I'm getting ready to put these frames in. I got my W's west and east, the east and the, I almost got these things put in the wrong place because the W and the E and my chicken scratch look so similar. So I've changed it, and now I've got this marked as one and one, so that this is the way this is going to go down in here, you know, because I want my angle to be right down here. But you can also see where I've cut that slot in the just a little tiny thing, not even a 16th of an inch down, just to give that glue somewhere to run and to separate, just so it just doesn't become such a piston in there. So I'm going to, I've got it set up straddling my work table and my table saw on these pieces of styrofoam. So I want to be able to just drive it straight down, and I'm going to use tight bond on this. I'm going to do one, I'm going to drive it home, so I think I have enough time where it's not going to set up too quick. And so instead of doing the whole epoxy thing, I don't think I need it because I think my joints are really tight. And so these sliding dovetails, you know, this is going to be, this case will be made completely with not one metallic piece of hardware in it until I put the screws through the cleat into the wall. So this is going to be all totally done with joinery. You know, the dovetailed ends, the case is kept together by the sliding dovetail panel, then the cleat is going to ride, is just going to get glued up into the dado, the rabbet into the dado, and you know, so, you know, and that's really, the weight of that's going to be gravity holding it down too, so the glue is just a little bit of extra, but this is going to be not one bit of steel hardware, no fasteners in it at all. So that's always a nice thing.
Okay, well, here's one frame down in here already. You can see how tight it was. There was no pressing it in by pushing it down or even hitting it with a hammer. I was hitting it with a hammer with a block of wood, and I was afraid I was going to break my frames. So I had to resort to actually pressing it in with hands or with pipe clamps. And so you'll see what a pain that was. But, you know, like I said, the humidity has come back in, and I think my panel has swelled up just a little bit, just enough. I don't want to mess with trying to pair things off right now. Because there's really nothing that can break, you know, on this sliding dovetail. I can't really crack my panel. The frame really can't break. I mean, unless I, like I said, if I was whacking on it so hard that I thought maybe I would pop the dominoes out or something, but nothing bad happened. But what I did is I'm going to get it started, and then I'm going to show you. Oh, this one actually seems like it's going to go in a little easier, but we'll see. The other one was a nightmare. I mean, I had to put, once I got it down as far as I could, I put a protective piece on here, and I just screwed it down. I had one clamp on either side, and I just would screw it until I lost threads. Then I'd back it off, and I'd do it. So I had to do it about five times to get it all the way down in there. But we'll see what's going to happen here. Okay, let's see if this one will go. I'm going to just turn the camera on and see if we can see a miracle happen here. Otherwise, I may have to get the clamps out. Oh, let's see. Come on, baby. Come on. See, what's happened is the humidity's come in and it's made those panels potato chip just a little bit. And this... Oh. Let me see if I can drive it a little bit.
This one's actually going better than the other one, so I may try to keep driving this a little to see if I can get it down without having to.
It's never easy. Never easy. Just when you think it's going to be easy, something happens. Okay, that looks like that's down. I'm going to check it here. That's flush on that side. Okay, I pulled it too far here. So I actually have to, I'm actually just going to use that block, this block, and I'm going to pull it up just a little bit. I'm going to reach and hit the frame, not the cabinet. Leave myself a little room here so I can, okay, well that's got that angle on it. Let me go on this side. That'll kind of compensate for that. Good. I think this side can go down just a little bit more though. One turn here. Okay. Pretty good. Good. Looks good. I don't have anything punched out. Looking good. I like it. Oh, son, that was something else. And you know what? There isn't really that much glue. I mean, I got some glue that I'm going to have to clean off, but it's really not that bad. I'm just going to let this set up a little bit.